In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create high-quality, professional, bifold church bulletins like this using Microsoft Publisher. Hello, this is David Towler with Supplemental Seminary. Appreciate you joining me today. And in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a professional, high-quality, bifold church bulletin that can be used. And I want you to stick around to the end of the video because I'm going to provide you with two links and how to get those concerning this tutorial and to go along with it, which would be a church bulletin checklist. And so it's going to go through each thing that you could look at each week to make sure that you don't miss a thing because you don't want to miss somebody's birthday, anniversary, or a certain event. You know, wars have started over less. And so you want to minimize those mistakes and to make sure that you have everything in there and just go by that general checklist. I'm going to show you how to get that. And then also this one we're looking at on the screen now, this template, this setup, I'm going to provide to you and I'm going to show you how to get that so you don't have to reinvent the wheel. Okay. So you get this template, you can download, open right up in Microsoft Publisher. And what you can do is just amend it and work around with it and adjust to, go along with your church and design and so forth. But anyway, let's get started out. And there's a couple things here I want you to notice. It's so important that when it comes to a church bulletin, I mean, those weeks come by really fast. And so you don't want to have to just redo the whole thing every week. You want a general setup, a general template. And so you can be just going in here and amending some things each and every week and going over that checklist I'm going to provide for you. And it'll make your life a whole lot easier. Trust me, we've been doing this for years and it's a whole lot easier. So anyway, the first thing you want to see right up here is I've got it brought up in Publisher. There's a couple things. Publisher can be a little complicated, but you can already see some things that have already been set up here. And I'll show you how to adjust those and amend it to work with your situation. Well, let's start up here at the top. You can see the date. And so you have this picture here that I can move around. I can adjust that. And what my wife does is she'll change that periodically. And you can find these pictures. I mean, you might put one of your church or you can search, Google and look at the images and, do a kind of a copy and a paste thing. Also, a good thing that you can do with Publisher, if I back out a little bit here and zoom out, you'll see I've got some pictures off here to the side. And so, like, if you want to change those out, just drag it over to the side and save that. That will not show up in the print. All right. So you can drag that over there. So if you're just adding an image, it just really helps. Of course, the insides right now, we're just doing print in black because if you get into color, you're really getting into a lot of cost. And I mean, you may be able to do that or want to do that. Of course, you're welcome to. It does look better, but it'll cost you. All right. So anyway, you're looking right here. We got this image. You see how I move that around. I can place that over here off the side and I can kind of adjust that. Now, something else I want to do is I want to zoom way in. You see, I'm doing that over here in the corner and I can zoom way in here because what I want to make sure of is these lines that you see here in the borders. All right. And I want to make sure that's in there. Okay. So that looks pretty good there. It's not touching. And then we get over here to the date. And what we can do there is just punch in example, change the date, whatever. Okay. So you can have the ability to do that. I'm going to change that back. Just doing the undo. All right. And when it comes, sometimes you really have to adjust on the fonts. So you may have, for example, if I come up here and I take this and right now it's at 26 font and it's got this Felix, whatever. And if I was to take that and I was shoot that up about 48, you see, I've lost all that. And so you can just highlight it. And of course I'd revert that back. 26 looks pretty good. So just play around with those fonts. Now this box that's created here that you see I'm dragging around, that is a text box. And so if you was able to use that, now if you're using Microsoft Word, you just type right on there, but you can't do that in Publisher. You got to create a text box, which you can go right up here at the top and where it says home, draw text box. I can just hit enter there and then I can draw a text box and adjust that like this and then place text in it. So let me delete that and get that out of the way. So you can see how that works, but you won't have to worry about that because I've already created a text box for you. So let me just put that back down here, and then we're going to just adjust it to fit in so it's within the borders. All right, see, like that. Okay, another thing is I want to show you, if you go over here to the left, all right, and you see this ruler that's across the top, hit Alt on your computer, all right, and then you can drag that over. You see this green line. All right, see that line I've created? Well, I didn't get all quite on the page. Let's do that again. All right, see that green line there? That way you can make sure there's a, and when you download this template, you'll see that green line there. So I'm gonna place that right here. And that allows you to make sure when you create a text box, see this one's a little out of the line on the green line, just so it's uniform and straight all the way down. All right, the next thing is going down here to the next box where you got your times of your services. And again, this is a picture with a text box. You see I'm dragging that around, so I can kind of adjust that a little bit to put text over that. All right, and then we come down to where it says this week. All right, and I'm gonna kind of zoom in a little bit more so you can see a little better. You know, when you get in here, you're gonna create these, and this one here is called a table where you have the different ones on each side. Okay, that's a table which is found up here. All right, and you can create it, you know, adding one or two, that'd be a two, and then come on down and how many rows you want. All right, so that's what we've created there. You can add or take away. You can go in here and hit delete object, okay? That would take some of that out. So let me backspace. All right, so anyway, you see, one of the things you want to cover in your bulletin is the things you have coming up this week. For this particular week, we have the date, the time, the event, who's going to be our guest speaker, and on down through here, you see we've taken care of the week. And then these are little informational boxes that you can add concerning the donation to the Bible Fund. You may have something else to put in there, just little informational boxes that we kind of put in there each week. All right, moving on the next side, we have here would be our welcome ministry, which we have a lady and a gentleman in the front greeting people. And we have special gifts for them coming in, first-time visitors and so forth. So we have that here. I've taken their last name off, but, you know, of course, we usually put that in there. And so that's the schedule that we have. So one of the things you want to add is schedules, children's church, Sunday school, greeting ministry, ushers, whatever you want there. All right, moving on down would be, these would be events coming up for the month. All right, monthly events. We have the information in here, which is a picnic that we're having with another church, and then our Lord's Supper quarterly business meeting. Down here, I've kind of made a box I'll change every once in a while, reminding people to connect with us on social media. And then here's some proposed church constitutional revisions. Then we have birthdays. Okay, that'll. And then what I'm going to do is go over here to the left. We want to be able to see the back of this. Okay, this is going to be page, what we call page 4. And so we go on the back, we're on the back of the bulletin now, and we have the nursery schedule, all right, projected. We have the children's church, and then always is good with this blank space here. You know, you got to amend that. Sometimes you won't have anything on the back. It just depends on if you're the first or the end of the month. But what we've done here is you can always add a text box for sermon notes. And I've read about how people like to have a little place to maybe make a note or write something. So that's a form you see there. Let's work with that a little bit, and I'll show you how we create it. What I'm going to do is drag this off to the side. All right, this text box, just to get rid of it. And then we'll make it again, okay? All right, so you see you got this big old blank space. Now, what I cannot do is go in here and just type. It's not going to do anything. See, I've got to have a text box. I'm getting an error there. Let me zoom back in a little bit more after it quit fusses at me. All right, so let's go on in here. And what I'm going to do is hover over this text box that you see here or should see, or even this one. And what I can do is hover over that and hit copy. All right, then it comes down here as blank space. And let's paste that. All right, so I didn't have to go up there and create another one. Then I just line it up on the green lines as you see here. All right, and then I bring it down to the bottom. I just keep dragging it on down here to come down to about maybe there. You want to leave a little space. That should be good enough. All right. Then we come up here. We don't have anything in it. So I can just type in, let's say sermon notes right there. Well, you see a couple problems. Number one, it's to the left. So I highlight that, go up here. We're going to center it. And then we're going to underline it, make it bold. And of course, we want to know the font, because this is just, let me zoom on in there so you can see what I'm talking about. All right, you have the font here. There's a couple ways you can do that. But we'll go up to the top. It's got Times New Roman, which is bland as you can get. So let's just change that to Arial. All right. Which I need the whole thing highlighted. All right, so now I've got a different font. Another thing I can do, I can make it italicized, whatever. All right, so you see that. Another thing, you could add a picture like we have here. All right, so what you want to do is be able to, the good thing is you'll get this template and you can go in here and toy around with it. Now, there's going to be some times you're going to delete something, but what you can always do is you have your undo. You can go back and toy around with it. I think the main things is really here is where it will be folded. And so you see the line there. You don't get these too close, but we've already taken care of all that for you, so you won't have to worry about it. Now you see on the front, I went to page one, that is totally blank. And when I'm talking about that front, there's several fronts that you can use, which would be the examples I'm going to show you here. You have several different fronts, okay, that you can have one that we have here that has our church on it. All right, that's been produced by a print shop, okay, because that's in color to cut down some of the costs. We don't have the ability to do that right now. And then you see some others here that are some other fronts that you can order from some, you know, companies. All right, so that would be page one. So obviously you're not printing that. And those are some good options there to really cut down. So as far as being in here, you're not going to print that. That's already populated. And then you're going to print this. Now, when you get to the printing part, that can be a little complicated. It depends on your printer. Now, when I go and print, I have to print and place it in there in a certain way. And the only way I know how to tell you to do this, depending on what printer you have, is to place that in there and put an X or something to mark your place. And then you're not going to print the whole thing. You may have a printer that prints on both sides. If you do, great, that'll save time. If not, you got to put it on one side, print one side, turn it over, and figure out which way it goes in there. So that can be challenging, but once you figure that out, you got it made. All right, so when I print this, you know, I'd go up to File and then Print. And actually for our printer at the church, what I have to do is go in here, and you see it's already just going to print in black. And I have to go over here and I have to print, in order to print the inside, I have to print 3, 2, all right, which is not going to print the whole thing, to print the inside. All right. So then I'll print that, and I found out how to place the paper in there. So I'll just print the inside. Then we take all those, we stack them, you know, and then we're going to place them back in, and I'm going to go in and put 1, 4, which is going to print page 1 and 4. Now there's nothing on page 1, but we just leave that blank, but we have to do that in order to get the back part placed on there like it should. All right, so that's something to be challenging. I can't really show you on this tutorial on how to do that exactly, depending on which printer you have. They're all different, but that's something you could look at. Now, what I want to show you is how to get this template real quick, is that you're going to go in. Okay, I want you to visit our website. In our website, you'll be able to download this church bulletin checklist so you don't miss a thing. And what I've created is 10 items that'll help you get started. You know, you got your date, church info, digital info, today, this week, this month, schedules, birthdays, anniversary, recently hospitalized, recently bereaved, highlighted information, and sermon notes. And so you want to be able to get that. You're going to be able to get that by going to my website, which will be a link in the video below, supplementalseminary.com. And then when you reach the site, you want to go over here and click on sign up. Okay, click on that. And then what you want to do is enter your information here, and it will redirect you to a site and a page that will allow you to get two things. Number one, the template we just went over here in Microsoft Publisher, this template here that you can work with and amend and share with your secretary at the church or whoever prints your bulletin. You'll have that. Then also, you'll have the checklist that we talked about, so you can make sure you don't miss a thing. All right. So appreciate you listening. and trust, if you haven't already, that you'll like and subscribe to this channel, Supplemental Seminary, when we deal with practical things you deal with in the ministry that leaves you often thinking, they didn't teach me this in Bible college.